Hello and welcome to this extremely different version of C++ Weekly, where you get to see my rather messy at the moment desk. Now, I am doing this episode because I have come across these two magazines, separated by 5 years and purchased in two different countries. This one was purchased first, the Python and C++ for Beginners, and this was purchased right before C++ on the Sea in 2019 while I was in the UK. This one was purchased in my hometown in Colorado in 2014, shortly after I got back from C++ on the Sea. These, as you'll see, are from two different publishers, BDM's Definitive Guide Series and Papercut. Now, looking at addresses and other things in here, I do not see anything that implies that they are from the same publisher, but there will be more on that later. This one cost £9.99 in 2019. This one cost $24.99. The UK listed price is £12.99. They are definitely both British publishers. We're going to start with the older one first. Now, the title of this episode is going to be something along the lines of I bought C++ magazine so that you don't have to. And you will see what I mean in a moment. Now, first of all, this says say hello to Python, but has a C++ logo here in the corner. They have the Python and C++ logos on each section, so it's kind of a pain to actually figure out what thing you're looking at. We're not going to spend any time on the Python stuff, except to maybe just quickly point out that these examples are very much the same, and that in some places this is completely unreadable. Tiny, tiny, small screenshot, and the code syntax highlighting definitely leaves something to be desired here. Okay, let's get ourselves to some actual C++ stuff. Say hello to C++. C++ is an excellent high-level programming language that's used in a multitude of technologies. Everything from your favorite mobile app and console and PC game to entire operating systems are developed with C++ at the core. Well, we can't really argue with that statement, can we? So there's some information on C++, and you can see that the first example that I want to draw your attention to is this right here. This is not how one would normally format a case statement, but let's just go with that and also note the weird formatting here. But this walks you through how to set up your own C++ compiler, what kind of computer, equipment, IDE you might be using, depending on operating system. Code blocks is what they end up recommending, which I find fascinating because I haven't heard of a lot of people using code blocks lately. But it covers many other IDEs, such as MonoDevelop, which is an excellent IDE for C++ development on desktop. And I know you probably can't see this, but I will do my best to zoom in on some of these things. This is clearly C#, because as we all know, MonoDevelop is actually a C# IDE, not a C++ IDE. Now, our fundamentals of programming in C++, this is not terrible. We can see here that they're not using std endl, so that's something for sure. And this somewhat important note that they didn't put any spaces between the parens on the end of the main declaration, which is actually completely irrelevant if you've seen any of my episodes on this topic. Of course, C++ was invented by Bjarne Stroustrup, so we do have to give a little shout out to Bjarne. Bjarne is absolutely the original creator of C++ here. Now, a personal pet peeve of mine is that they do actually recommend using namespace std, and we'll see that most of the examples after this very first one using namespace in them. I'm not going to read every word of this or anything, of course. Now, there's an important note on the importance of commenting, and it is using some assembly that I'm not sure what this is. It could be Z80, perhaps? I'm not sure. Okay, let's get to some good stuff here. it shows you declaring and then assigning values to your variables here, which is fine, but of course goes against most best practices from C++ at this point. And then it does kind of clean that up a little bit by suggesting that you can initialize them at the same time of declaration, which is nice. But then I am going to be incredibly annoyed with this particular block of code. So why not have done radius equals 1.5. And then on the next line down, we can just go ahead and add double right here, area equals pi times radius, that's better, or even more better perhaps would be to just let us use auto here. Now they do introduce auto a little bit later in these things, and they talk about the new C++ 11 from this magazine that was published in 2019. Not a whole lot to say here, except they've gone and reverted back to doing this declaration and then assignment. Please, please, if you're going to do this, we should merge those onto one line, which then also allows us to use the const keyword. And I will give them a little bit of a pass for waiting to declare const later, but they also have this double, like, double pi equals whatever. Now, I know you're all fans of my channel, and this really should be something like constexpr, you know, pi, whatever, equals something, because pi is a fairly well-known universal constant. This isn't something that we need to be able to mutate at runtime. So I think this is a pretty good time to introduce const at the very least, even if you're not introducing constexpr. And again, they did avoid endl, but, and this is, you know, really a super pet peeve of mine, that when you aren't taking care to properly format code samples, you end up with things like this, where they've got the Unicode open quote and close quote around the string, which is C++ code that's simply not going to compile. And then you can see that at some point this was edited and you end up with an open quote and an open quote on one string, which is definitely really wrong. I mean, strings, I guess, they're talking about, no, there's a standard string and they're talking about C strings over here. So this isn't too bad, talking about manipulating values. But again, back to this example here, where we're declaring and then assigning the value for area, please just move this declaration down to this line for these examples. Input, output, this is certainly going to be good. Okay, get line, that's not terrible. Still with the using namespace, which you know that I don't like. Character literals, okay. This is what we already talked about. They actually mean string literals here, not character literals. These are escape sequences. Maybe they meant to say escape sequences on this page. I'm not sure. Oh, here we go. This is great. This is a magazine made in 2019, and they have pound define for their constants. Again, this is constexpr, not pound define. Aye. This is okay. Now they're using const int. But now we're to a pound define for pi, which I guess is okay because, well, I don't know. But we are using const. Okay, const has been introduced. Fine. That's something. So if you're going through this strictly in order, all right, maybe it makes sense. Loops and decision making. Windows.h so that we can use sleep. Now that's an interesting decision because as of C++ 11, we actually do have a thread sleep that can be used and we don't need to include Windows.h. I don't think it's a bad thing to introduce plus equals one or perhaps plus plus num at this point, but I guess you can do num equals num plus one. These for loops are relatively sane, it looks like. Oh, but all of a sudden, why did we start using endl? I don't understand. You were using the backslash n before you introduced what the escape sequences were. And then once you introduced the escape sequences, now you're using endl. I don't understand. And look at this, endl just continues throughout this code now. Why? Why did you do that? I don't understand. If statements, okay, this is reasonable. We introduce if statements one thing at a time. But again, with the endl here, and oh, that's nice, a new line and an endl. Let's be redundantly redundant. All right, small chunks of code, comments, plan ahead, math, backups. How about instead you mention something like, I don't know, maybe GitHub? How about source control? That sounds better than just saying making backups, but okay. This one absolutely floors me. So they're talking about undeclared identifiers as being common mistakes, and I can see this, okay? You go to compile this code and it tells you X hasn't been declared yet. That's fair. And then you look at this code, and if you're missing a semicolon, like you are here, then that's going to be a bug. But this example, which they have repeated multiple times in here, I just can't even wrap my head around. This is definitely a Python programmer who wrote this example. I challenge you to go ahead and tell me if you know by glancing at this, whether this is going to output just A or just D or A, B, C, and D, and what exactly is going to happen here. You need to know the rules of operator precedence in C and C++ to know what that's going to print. And then this is a completely unreadable screenshot, and another completely unreadable screenshot because it is far too tiny. Now, this mentions extra semicolons as a beginner mistake, and I don't even know where this extra semicolon is that they're talking about. Yeah, but I don't know. I don't see it. So there's, you know, usually extra semicolons aren't actually a bug. I can add like 5 extra semicolons right here if I really wanted to, and it's still going to compile just fine. Too many braces. Okay, that's fair. You know, brace randomly in the middle of the code, that's going to be a problem. Forgetting to initialize variables. Yeah, so go ahead and make them const or something. Force yourself to initialize them, or use auto, which forces you to initialize. All right, so that pretty much wraps up this magazine. Ooh, code repository. Share your code. No, this seems to be code that other people have shared. I don't know. All right. That was From Python and C++ for Beginners from 2019 from BDM Publishing. Now let's bring you to the Ultimate Coding Manual from Papercut Publishing. This one covers Raspberry Pi programming, Python programming. I can master Linux, and I can unlock the power of C++ programming. Expert coding projects, this is great. But we're just going to focus on the C++ aspect of this. Now remember, completely different publisher, 5 years apart, bought in 2 different countries, but they are both printed in the UK. Okay, introducing C++. So just like the other one, they go through different IDEs that one might install. Here's some facts and figures about C++. Equipment that you might need, including operating system, IDE, that kind of thing. Look, a little note about Bjarne. Let's see. C++ was invented by Danish student Bjarne Strustrup in 1979 as a part of his PhD thesis. Initially, C++ was called C with classes, which added features to the already popular C programming language while making it a more user-friendly environment. That seems vaguely familiar. All right, computer equipment that you might need. This looks also vaguely familiar. Well, surely the rest of the content in this has been updated and changed for 5 years later. My first C++ program. Look, we've got backslash n's. That looks all right, as long as that's the thing I'm going to focus on. They still insist on doing this using namespace std. We've got slightly better quotes here, but it's still the open quote and close quote Unicode characters. Again, some random, I'm pretty sure that that's Z80. I think there's a good chance that's Z80 assembly. And the exact same things over and over again here about why did I declare area to assign it one statement later? I should have just moved that declaration down. And really, there's not a whole lot here to say. This is the exact same things over again. And that's it. I have mastered C++ in these 5 pages of code or so. Anyhow, I'm going to leave this here. This is just absolutely ridiculous. I bought these magazines so that you don't have to. The formatting is bad. The examples are wrong in some cases, particularly that thing with the comma separation on C out. I can't even believe what I'm looking at in that code. And the weird mix match of using backslash n versus endl and not introducing those things in the right order. And then even talking about pound defines when you're trying to get someone to master C++11, I don't understand. C++ beginner mistakes. And we have this thing that I've already harped on several times that I just don't understand. Well, hopefully this was an interesting aside into C++ here, and I will catch you in the next episode.